Hey everybody, my name is Kenny and you're watching Brave the Wilds on YouTube. Today, I'm going to show you my hygiene, first aid, and repair kit. Stay tuned. So when it comes to first aid, there's a fine line. A lot of people tend to carry a lot of kit, a lot of first aid kit, and then there's those people out there that carry absolutely nothing. And I don't think either one of them are quite right. I think there's a good balance between. I think you should have a good kit that is very comprehensive enough to where you can perform, basic cleaning of wounds and things like that. But it doesn't have to be enough stuff where you can, you know, do surgery with it. So what I carry is I carry just a 1-quart Ziploc bag that has my actual kit in it to keep it nice and waterproof. And this is just a travel mesh kind of pouch. And what it has in it is everything I need for basic first aid, hygiene, and then a little bit of repair as well. So go ahead and open it up. It doesn't have a lot of volume of stuff, but it's very comprehensive. I have one bandana, good for a washcloth mainly, and tying up wounds, filtering water, lots and lots of things for a cotton bandana can be used for, as long as it's cotton. I have just a bar of soap, cheap stuff from the hotel. As soon as you use it on like a 3-day trip, just throw it away and get another one. I'll go ahead and put these over here. This will actually last quite a while, depending on how much you use it, I guess, but it will last quite a number of days. Some toothpaste. I usually keep a toothbrush in here as well, but I've left that out, but I normally keep one in there. So this is good for hygiene right here. And then a little bit of preventative maintenance, some sunscreen right here, and this is SPF 30. And then that's pretty much what I have for hygiene. Very, very small kit, but it's pretty comprehensive enough to keep you clean while you're out there for a few days in the woods. When it comes to first aid, the biggest thing is preventing infection. So I keep a pretty good sized bottle of Neosporin in there. That'll be plenty enough for anything that you might experience on a couple day trip. I keep in here, believe it or not, this is one pair of latex gloves. Now you gotta be careful when you're treating people to ask if they're allergic to latex or not, because that can become a problem if they are. So these are actually, I have a pair of black ones, or I have a pack of black ones that aren't latex. So I should probably switch them out, but make sure you're careful with that. But this is, there's one glove and there's the other, so that way you can easily prevent infection if your hands are dirty and you're trying to clean up a wound on someone else. Keep a pair of fingernail clippers. They're too small to really, you know, kind of leave out. They're super small. They don't weigh hardly anything, so you might as well take them. And then in here, I keep some medication. It's basically just ibuprofen painkillers. So if you get an injury or something like that, easy to kind of kill some of the pain. It's probably a good idea to carry some antihistamines in there as well for bee stings and things like that. Then we go to the rest of first aid. I keep mainly just a lot of gauze and big band-aids. This is a big band-aid for larger scrapes and cuts. Keep quite a few different assortments of regular smaller band-aids, a little bit of just spot ones. A little bit smaller than that, and a little bit smaller. Again, like I said, the main thing is keeping things clean, so I have lots of these antiseptic wipes. These are actually not alcohol, so that's good, so that way they won't sting so bad. I'm not sure quite what is in these. These were given to me by a paramedic, so I know they're good quality. I'm just not sure what their main ingredient is. I'm not sure if it's peroxide or something else like that. But anyway, I've got 4 of those right there. So that way it'll be good for any of that. And then the only thing I have in here for repair, really, is a cloth sail needle. I don't carry any thread because I have Bankline in my kit. And Bankline's the best thread I know because you can split it apart really well and then just feed it through this nice big eyelet. And you can do any repairs you need to do to your pack, your footwear. I wouldn't necessarily sew up my arm with it. It's a bit big for that, but I guess you could if you had to. Again, another big thing of gauze. This is 3 inches by 4 inches. Another one, and another one. So as you can see, you know, this is a pretty comprehensive kit. It doesn't have anything in here that is useless or extra. I don't carry, you know, shears or a tourniquet or anything like that, because I think that's a bit overzealous when it comes to first aid. If you had to use a tourniquet, this bandana would work well. So there's lots of things that I don't carry because they just add on extra weight when they're 95% of the chance, or 95% of the time they're not going to be used. So I carry just a little bit of stuff to keep you going. Easily keep yourself clean for 3 days or longer With this, bar soap easy to switch out when you're done with the trip, Neosporin and antiseptic towels to disinfect any wounds you have, and then you've got something to cover up here. I don't carry any medical tape because I have duct tape in here. I've got some Gorilla tape, and that stuff's going to work just as well as any medical tape. It might rip off a little bit of hair, but that's not that big of a deal. So I'm not going to be redundant in that necessarily. I really don't need it. And then Band-Aids for if you're going with anybody and they're a wussy and they need a tiny little Band-Aid, you got one for them. So that's pretty much it, you know, pretty comprehensive. And it's worked well for me, and I haven't had a problem with it. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Have a good day, and I'll see you on the next video.